Note, rational numbers are of the form p by q. We know rational numbers can be write in the form of p by q, where q is not equal to 0. And expansion of p by q, as either a terminating decimal expansion or non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. Okay, rational number, any rational number we can write in the form of p by q. Okay, so here q is not equal to 0. So this rational number we can expect expansion in the form of terminating on or non-terminating. Okay, what is terminating and non-terminating? See these examples: 1.2, 2.7, 5.6. These numbers are terminating decimals. Okay, terminating or non-repeating decimals. What is non-terminating? See, 1.21, 21, and so on. Here decimals are repeating, it keeps going on. So this number is non-terminating decimal. Okay, repeating decimal. Next, 1.21567 63, and so on. So this number also repeating decimal. Okay, is it okay? Next, theorem 1 says that let x be a rational number. X is a rational number. We know rational numbers we can write in the form of p by q, whose decimal expansion terminates. This is the terminating rational number. Okay, then x can be expressed in the form of p and q, where p and q are coprimes. Okay, here p and q are coprimes, and prime factorization of q is of the form 2 power n into 5 power m, where n and m are non-negative integer. Here x is terminating rational number. So x can be write in the form of p by q. Okay, here prime factorization of q, here p and q are coprimes. Prime factorization of q in the form of 2 power n and 5 power m. So this is x. This x is terminating rational number. See this example, 1.3 is terminating rational number. So 1.3 we can write in the form of 13/10. Okay, here 10 is, prime factorization of 10 is 2 into 5. Okay, here q equal to, we can write 2 power 1 and 5 power 1. 2 power 1 into 5 power 1. Okay, so this is terminating rational number. Okay, next example, 1.2 is terminating rational number. 1.2 is 12/10. 10 can be write in the form of prime factorization 2 into 5. So q is write in the form of 2 power 1 and 5 power 1. So this is terminating rational number. Okay, is it clear? Next, theorem 2. If in case q is not write in the form of 2 power n and 5 power m. Okay, q is not equal to 2 power n and 5 power m form. This is non-terminating decimal. We know q equal to write in the form of 2 power n and 5 power 1. It is terminating. We can't write in the form of 2 power n and 5 power n. This is non-terminating. See this example, 1/3. Here 3 is not write in the form of 2 power n and 5 power m. So it is non-terminating. So 3 divides 1, 0.1, point. So this is 10. 3 3 is 9. Remainder is 1. So we have point. So take 0, 1 0. 3 3 is 9. Remainder 1. In 3 3 is 9. Okay. So it keeps going on. 0.333 and so on. Okay. It is non-terminating. It is repeating decimal. Is nothing but reoccurring. Okay. Reoccurring decimals. Okay. Is it clear? So what we have discussed. Rational number we can write in the form of P by Q. Here Q is not equal to 0. Rational number we can express it in the form of either terminating or non-terminating. Terminating examples are 1.2, 2.7, 5.6 and so on. Non-terminating or repeating. It means it is repeating decimals. For example, 1.2121 and so on. Okay. Next, theorem 1 says that rational number we can write in the form of P by Q. Here P and Q are co-primes. Q prime factorization of Q is write in the form of 2 power n and 5 power m. So this is terminating rational number. We can't write in the 2 power n and 5 power m. It is non-terminating. It is repeating decimals. Okay.